Hello, welcome to Spine Educational Channel. In this video, I will show you how I animated Mjolnir in Spine. I'm using 4.0 version and I'm using a lot of VFX, so yeah, this video is about effects and it's gonna be short. So if you are looking for the longer version, go ahead, skip this video and check the stream I did recently. I will leave the link up here on the screen and down below in the description. But if you are staying with me, I will explain how I did right now in this video. I will also put the link to the project files so you can download in the description. But please make sure you don't use those effects in your projects since they are under the license. Nice, nice. Let's jump into the spine and see where do we start. I've separated the project into 9 different animations, so we can go and check them one by one. First animation would be Mjolnir itself. It falls from the sky and nothing special. Just make sure when it hits the ground, motion ends abruptly, rather than by slowing down. Second animation is coming with a ray and complementing yellow color on Mjolnir. The ray smoothens the movement, while the yellow color makes sure Mjolnir is noticeable enough. Checking third animation. Here we have more work done on the rays. The same narrow ray that we had in previous animation is expanding into this one, which changes color to blue. We will need that blue color later, when we introduce blue electric rays. We have new rays moving up, nothing special, and we have some detailed texture that glows over Mjolnir. Just an image. Oh, and this glare. This is its default animation. And this one is deformed using link meshes. If you are not familiar with the link meshes, check this video on the screen. Fourth animation brings us to one technique that I use a lot when animate impacts. We have two linked meshes that use one explosion sequence. Note that one of the meshes is only the half of the effect. The full one I placed on the ground in corresponding perspective by deforming the mesh in the setup mode, while the half one I located vertically to give 3D effect. This way I can squeeze most of the original sequence. In the next animation, we have more impact effects, dust and glowing particles. The only thing that I advise you here is to cut symmetric sequence such as those into half and flip them in spine. That way you will save space in the final atlas. Sixth animation comes with a crack on the ground and magic circle spinning on it. Well, the crack is very simple, I just scale it very quickly, while the circle is a bit tricky. If you don't know yet, in spine, if you scale a bone by one axis, children bones can be rotated inside that distorted space. For instance, if I bring that scale back, you will see that we are working with a simple 2D circle, which simply rotates in its local space. We can even shear the parent bone, child bone will continue spinning in its local space. Next animation adds more richness to the impact. Not much to say here, I just keyed a bunch of new sequences, hoping that Final Atlas will not explode. Stay with me, at the end of the video I will show you exported atlas and maybe ways to optimize it. Just before moving to the next animation, let me show you one preset in Graphio. I used it for those two rocks that bounce on the ground several times. I will open Graphio and isolate translate y-axis for that left rock. This is correct one. You can see that the moment it bounces from the ground, curve breaks, which is proper bounce for hard rocks. Now let's assume we have standard curve, the automatic one, which we can set by clicking on this button. Okay, cool. So to make the bottom parts of the curve break sharply, we just need to select all bottom keys and hit this button. Nice, looks good to me. Moving to the next animation. Oh yeah, I love this iteration. So simple, but adds so much richness. So, we have a few frames of this electric rays. I've created linked mesh from it and bound edges to the bones. Next, I have just positioned those two bones in animation, moved for a few frames, and then instantly changed their position. I love it. Last animation is nothing new. Some electric sparks flowing up, but with deformation, we aligned it over the surface of Mjolnir. And looks good, right? Let's check the final polished look. Little shaking. Some more effects, and we get this. Now, let's quickly check the exported atlas. Oof, so much effects. But we are in 1000k square. which is not bad, I think. Anyway, just make sure you learn how to animate VFX. There are always ways to optimize them. If you want to dig in more, you have 2-hour stream waiting for you in description. Or go watch this short video explaining why and when you should use VFX in Spine. Thank you for watching, and special thanks to those fantastic people who support this channel. Yeah, we're 5 supporters. Thank you.